Yeah, give me the words and I got the flow. See, I don't gotta write, I got the Holy Ghost. Yeah, that's called a ghost writer. Jeremiah 5 and 14, that's so fire. Isaiah 14 and when I retire, out of captivity, I broke the iron. Who that is coming out of Mount Zion? Woolly head, looking like a lion.
1,000 men marching with no drums on, no trombone, just boots on. Use our voices screaming out, take care of your homes, take care of your wives, take care of your own.
Now we standing out here in the valley of the bones. This place called America, this is not your home. This is like a tomb, place where you died at. Now I resurrected, trying to bring the 12 tribes back.
I came on a slave ship and
I ain't even like that.
Put my neck in a rope and I couldn't even fight back.
Four Corners News. That's right, where the truth speaks. I am Captain Zakar, and to my left,
Officer Pat GL.
To his left,
Officer Daniel.
And to his left,
Officer Azaniah.
And to his left,
Officer Samuel.
And we make up Four Corners News.
That's right.
Let's get straight to it, man. Let's get into the hot news of the week.
That's
Let's
right.
get into it, man.
Hey, turn me up, man.
As you can see, man, we had a passing of one person out there in the world that actually spoke truth about the daggone black woman. The Lord took him away. Read that for us. Who I got reading for me? Where we at? We got anybody reading back for me? All right, never mind. We'll read it ourselves. All right. Breaking news. Kevin Samuels, man, he passed away at 56. It says that he passed away of a heart attack, cardiac arrest. Man, it was his time to go, man. When I first saw this, man, I was thinking like, damn, them Red Bulls caught up with him, man.
Yeah, same thing I said when I saw that.
Yeah.
I was like, he's the Red Bulls.
And I'm not shocked that he passed away, because, you know, people die every day. As you know, you can't go past when the Lord says you can go past.
Right.
What
right.
really shocked me about this is the evil ass black women.
Bring it out.
That's right.
You evil ass black women
evil.
That are happy.
Ripping
happy that he's dead. You know, the scriptures talk about rejoice not over thy greatest enemy. Although he wasn't even your enemy, he was literally just telling you the truth about who you really are. You was mad at him, and you're glad that he's dead only because he told you about yourself.
Come on now,
Cap,
y'all.
Yeah, Cap, that comes back to proving that the Bible is such a true book. Mm-hmm. When the Lord says they hate them that rebuke at the gate, any type of correction our people get from one another, it automatically makes you public enemy number
automatically.
One.
You know what that shows, too? That shows that women lack account of accountability.
Yeah. Right,
because all it is just correction to help fix you, but they don't want to be fixed
The thing is, it's like it ain't like he wasn't speaking the truth, dude.
Right.
35, 40 years old, dude. People ain't out here marrying you like 20-year-olds.
No.
Sexual market value has been
decreased.
It's low, man. Be honest with yourself. You can get sex, but marriage is different. And they hated him for telling him you ain't nothing but an old hoe.
Damn.
You won't be mad. Be mad at Captain Zakar. I'm gonna tell you, you ain't nothing but if you're out there in the world and you ain't married and you're quote unquote dating, you ain't nothing but an old hoe.
Yeah. Right, that's right.
It is what it is, man. Just be bad at us, man.
She's nothing but an old hoe with old dreams.
Old dreams, man. With the, you know, repent and have a born again vagina. Damn.
All your history.
Yeah, that's it, man.
The league,
man. Hey, also, man. Also, in the hot news that we got out here today, man. It's you know, a lot of these. Well, the pressures of today's world with these millennials. You know, it's getting to be too much for a lot of them, you know. They don't know, with social media, it's an increase of pressure on these kids to keep up with the Joneses and to be cool and get likes and things of that nature.
Right.
A young girl committed suicide that was a cheerleader of a historically black college. Let's pull that up for him. Let's pull that up. Let's read that for him, officer.
I've written so many suicide notes in my life, but finally I've reached my end.
Southern University cheerleader, 19, is found dead just hours after posting heartbreaking final Instagram message blaming COVID and injury for her depression.
There you go. So you see that they don't know how to handle the thing because this is a trying time, man. Real talk. This is the time like we've never seen on earth. It speaks about that in Daniel. That this would be a time that was never since before seen. That's speaking about World War III, but leading up to that, things are not going to get better like Christianity keeps telling you. The world is not going to go back to the good. There will never be the good old days.
Right, right. It's now, it's only now that we are in a society where one Instagram post can ruin a millennial's life.
The hell is this?
Mm-hmm. That's crazy.
Or Instagram posts can get you canceled.
Right. Yeah.
We live in that, and that can send you into depression like it did with this young girl that she ultimately took her life. Suicide is not the way out. Repentance is.
Right.
Repentance is the way out, not suicide, because that alleviates all the pressure, the cares of this world. Go to the next thing, the bullet points of it, to see what that article was speaking about. Let's pull it up. Read it for us, officer.
A Louisiana college is mourning the death of a freshman cheerleader found dead.
Damn. 19 years old? Go ahead.
After posting a lengthy suicide note on social media.
Read on.
Ariana Miller, 19.
Arlana. I think it says Arlana.
Yes. Arlana Miller, 19, attended Southern University in A&M College in Baton Rouge.
Baton Rouge. Baton. That guy is from London. Go ahead.
France.
Baton Rouge.
In Baton Rouge. She penned heartbreaking Instagram posts prior to being found dead Wednesday.
Mm.
Miller's troubling final post showed she had struggled in her classes at the historically black college where she majored in agriculture. I've been surrounded by people who may have honestly thought that I was okay, but I haven't been okay for a while, Miller wrote. Miller said she failed to follow her own advice and thanked her mother. I've written so many suicide notes in my life, but finally I've reached my end.
Check this out. 19. That girl's only 19.
Damn.
She's only been on the earth for 19 years. She only knew that the earth or you know, like a lot of us when we was young, the world didn't make sense until we hit the age of reasoning.
Yeah. Right. Right.
A lot of us, it was that first time that we did something we wasn't supposed to do. Right. Then the world made sense. Like, damn, this is why the world turns right here. You know what I'm talking about, all
right? Right.
But she was only been here for 19 years. Ain't even got that much life experience. But she got to the point, social media, Instagram, that she said, I'm done with this world at 19 years old. And that's how bad it's getting.
You know what's crazy that I'm just starting to realize is by us reading this article is pretty much she wrote many suicide letters.
That means
nobody has been paying attention to her.
Good point.
Because her mom should be following her on Instagram to figure out what she's posting.
Yeah,
or her mom's supposed to be on social media. Somebody that's supposed to care be on social
media.
That's
why God said, now see, now if you watch FCN, Four Corners News, you understand why God wrote Malachi 3:16.
They
that fear the Lord spoke often. Why? Because we in troubled times and the pressures of this world, what does it say in Ezra, that the mind museth upon many things.
And
weigheth and presseth down the soul. That's called depression. That's why God said those that believe spoke often, so you can encourage each other to keep on keeping on in these last days.
That's right.
That's why we got to talk to each other so none of us end up in a situation like this young girl at 19 years old. All right. Hey, what else we got in the hot news? I think it's Black Lives Matter, right? Black Lives Matter out here. Let's read that, officer. Anybody on there on the boards? Can we get the our theme songs? Okay. Let's read that.
Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter has left Black Americans worse off since the movement began, experts say.
You know what that goes back? What are you thinking, officer?
Black Lives Matter is a joke.
It was a joke.
It's a joke.
Yeah.
Because they trying to profit off Black people dying.
There you go. That's it. They
when
got
the money. Is there.
They got
I'm
rich.
Sorry, go ahead.
But check this out. You know what hit that when I read that? What first thing popped up in my mind?
Go ahead.
What was that Deuteronomy where it says that no man shall save thee. Now God magnified his word. No organization shall save thee.
Yep. You know that's the sad part. We keep trying to find different ways instead of going straight to God.
That's it.
Say, you know what? Let me try something else. No matter how much time we get duped, we say, let me try something else.
You know that. What else? Now, this is the wise person is going to open their eyes and be like, damn, them Israelites is right. We've tried voting. Mm-hmm. We've tried assimilation, mm-hmm. education. Hell, we tried crypto. we tried quick stocks. Get rich quick screen schemes.
Bitcoin.
We tried drugs.
Hey, Cap, you know what's crazy? When 2020 first started, a lot of our people got into the stock market.
Yeah.
Because it was crashing. It was like, it's time to make money 2021. Yeah. And then 2022, boom.
Right back down.
Hey, Cap. I'm one of those crypto Jews. I just checked mine.
Get in and get out, yeah. Man. You know, I just take when you get profits.
I looked at it, a couple months back. I was like, oh, praise to the Most High. God is blessing me. I look now. Oh, no. What happened
you
to the blessing?
Oh, my God. But that's what. Hey, go to the main point in that article, man, and let's see what they was talking about. Hot news.
I would argue that on balance, these communities are worse off because by Black Lives Matter overemphasizing the role of police, they've changed police behavior for the worse.
For the worse. Go ahead.
The Manhattan Institute's Jason Riley told Fox News Digital in a phone interview. In other words, police do become more cautious.
Now, check this out. That is the truth. You know how we know this is that it's become worse and they're more cautious? What happens when we call the police? We called the police before. 20. Sometimes they don't even show up,
yep.
Or it takes them an hour to get there.
Yep.
Or stuff could have been done happen by then.
Right.
Or
they come afterwards.
Afterwards.
It's all done.
Yeah. Or we don't need y'all no more.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Or you become the suspect itself. You call trying to, defend and protect the community, but
right.
Nigga, you are the perp.
Yeah. Yeah, but
lock
that's what
up.
Happened.
The
that's,
bullet
that's
hole
how
gets
become
shot
worse.
At you.
Sometimes they don't even show up. And you know, if I'm lying, I'm flying, and I'm sitting in a chair right now. You call police, and it'd be 30 minutes. Unless somebody gets shot or dead, then they show up quick. But other than that, they don't even show up half the time. It'll be 20, 30 minutes later. So it has become worse because Black Lives Matter. Pull up the article. Go back to it. Let's read that main point. In it. Go ahead.
In other words, police do become more cautious. They're less likely to get out of their cars and engage with people in the community.
Mm-hmm.
And to the extent that police are less proactive, the criminals have run of the place.
Remember, just a few weeks ago, we brought out that one of the, I don't know what they call him. He's not the mayor, but he's like one of the city officials of Chicago. Mm-hmm. What did he say? Chicago is the land of the lost.
Yeah.
It's got so bad that the police, like I said, they don't even get out the cars. The criminals know now that it ain't that many. Hell, you go to a fast food restaurant and all the fast food side of places got what? Now hiring.
That was
so
nice.
If they hiring and you gotta wait long times to get your damn food, guess what's going on with the police? You better survive till we get there. You die. We'll clean you up after.
You know if a city is bad, if you go into a neighborhood restaurant where you have to go and order through a bulletproof glass.
Yeah.
Wait,
that
no
happens
way,
us
boy.
We went to Chicago.
That means they steps away from putting that now hiring sign in front of the police department.
Yeah. That's exactly what's happening, man. That goes in to show you what God said, man. No man shall save thee, not even a damn organization.
Real?
The only thing that is going to get us out of the predicament that we are in is repentance.
Right.
Returning to God. Keeping the commandments and the faith in his son, Jesus Christ.
That's
other than that,
right.
God is letting you know. With that right there, that article right there, God's letting you know you have no other option.
Right.
You have the way out. It's going to continue to get worse before it gets better. And the only way it's going to get better is when you seek God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul.
That's right.
And one main important aspect that article is showing about Black Lives Matter is God is literally telling you, even though you made a movement or you made rose awareness to black on Impression. Blue crime, violence type stuff, black lives do not matter.
Right.
That's
right.
The ultimate point
good
that
point.
Our people
good
have
point.
To see.
That's a good point right there. Black lives do not matter ultimately to the white man. All right. Hey, pull up. What else is going on in the news? In the hot news, man. We do got some good news though. Out of the hot news, black churches are closing down. Oh, praise the Most High! Read that form, officer.
Churches are closing in predominantly black communities.
Oh, praise to the Most High, man. Read on.
Why public health officials should be concerned.
Man, we ain't worried about no damn public health officials. That is the infinite wisdom of the Most High. Now, look at this. We didn't even think about this. See, this is the infinite wisdom of Most High. But we was all like, man, you got to wash your hands. You got to stay 6 feet away. Wear a mask. We got to get online and we got to do that. Cut down the numbers. God's like, hey, man, hey, stop worrying, man. Yeah. I'm going to help y'all out on the back end. Y'all just don't know. Right. I'm going to close down these damn cemeteries.
Right.
These damn death traps called churches. I'm going to close them down.
Pimp house.
These pimp houses through Corona. Right. I'm going to close these places down. Go to the main point in that article. Let's read that, man.
For decades, churches have been central pillars of community health.
Telling lies. They come. They try to mix it with community health. Telling lies, dude. That's what they have been central for.
People, go ahead. People go in there sick and still come out sick.
Don't damn. Know,
talking about come out worse.
Right. Come out worse.
People come in there trying to be saved, and they end up being on crack.
Yeah. Really? Go ahead. Read that. Read that for him, officer.
In predominantly black communities, compensating for a highly inequitable public health infrastructure. The current COVID-19 pandemic has highlighted the important role that churches have played as trusted authorities in black and Latino communities in disseminating information and in serving as points of access for COVID-19 testing and vaccine rollouts. Mm-hmm. While positive health and well-being in the communities served by these churches ultimately requires significant government investments in public health and healthcare access points and resources, churches embedded in predominantly black communities will continue to be important providers of basic health-related services in their communities.
Now, check this out. They're only predominantly or sent pillars of health when they want us to get the mosquito bite try out some new damn type of drug that they have made up.
Yep.
Where's the black church been a pillar of in the community for AIDS? Where they been a pillar of community for STDs? And gonorrhea, where you at? Where you administering shots for that? But when it come to COVID-19, they open up their doors. For that, come in here and get this shot because we get money behind this.
Yeah, you just hit it right on the head because I was going to say because the money is rolling in. Because with that, if the money is not rolling in, the Christian church don't have nothing to do with
damn.
It.
Damn.
What's wrong with you?
Damn, good at point all. Right there, babe.
What's wrong with y'all?
Damn, they don't even open the door. Remember T.D. Jakes? He, I don't know where it was. I forget it. He said he came to a church. Oh, he went to a church.
Right.
And the person wanted to go up and shake his hand, and they told him you have to give $25,000 or $20,000 donation to check his hand. That's what the Christian church is coming.
What's that, that famous Edomite? That famous Edomite that closed down his church.
Joel Osteen.
It was Joel Osteen. He closed down his church when
when that hurricane hit. No more y'all. No more black and Mexicans. Worry about your own health out there as the tornado hurricane comes through.
You know what that reminds me of? The movie that we made a commentary of with the FCN movie review, which was American Refugee.
American Refugee.
That's that same situation that ended up happening. He's pulling a play from his forefather's playbook. No Jake is going to get in, but his people, they are right.
Yep, that's it.
Shalom, Israel. This is Bishop Nathaniel. I want you to know that you can view all our Sabbath classes live on IUIC TV. That's right. I said on IUIC TV. Download the app today. Shalom. Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I have an important message about your leaders in the Christian church. Your bishops, pastors, reverends, and ministers are all lying to you and leading you straight to damnation. The truth is,
You so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans are the biblical Israelites, according to Deuteronomy chapter 28. Jesus Christ is a black man with white wool hair, according to Revelation chapter 1, verses 14 and 15. We as the Israelites must keep the commandments in the faith of Christ to receive salvation, as it is written in Revelation chapter 14, verse 12. I've challenged and debated Christian authorities all over the world on these issues. Not one of them has been able to negate this truth. Your pastors have led you astray, worshiping pagan holidays and false gods, just as in the days of old. So join us on our mission to restore the true nation of Israel before the decree goes forth. The work is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Visit our website at israelunite.org or call us at 855-484-4842 to learn more and visit our schools. Shalom.